Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study how to design a binary tree from given pre-order and post-order traversal sequence. These type of problems are always asked in examination for 10 marks. In this example, they have not given us the in-order sequence, so it is difficult for a user to find the left and right child of the tree. To find the root node of this tree, we are going to use the pre-order sequence. So as we know, in pre-order sequence, the root always comes at the beginning. So the root of this tree is node G. We'll draw it first. After getting the root node, we'll take the next element from the pre-order sequence itself. So the element is F, and then we'll check it into the tree that in post order sequence where it appears. If you see, G is the root node and F is appearing towards left hand side of node G, it means it is the part of that tree. So we draw it to the left hand side of node G. So the rule says that whenever the coming elements comes into the binary tree, we have to check whether the root node has left and right child or not. If the left child is and right child is not there, it means both are missing, then the coming element, always the coming element should be placed to the left hand side. If the left element is occupied, then the coming element must be placed to the right side. After placing node F, now we'll take the next element from the pre-order sequence, that is node D, and then we'll go to check it into the post order sequence where it appears. It appears before G, it means it comes below node G, it is a part of node G, but it also before node F, it means it is the part of node F. It must be placed in the tree of a node F. So it should be placed below node F. It means we have to check here, is there any left and right child to node F? No, both are missing. So in that situation, we have to place that coming node D to the left hand side of node F. Now again we will take the next element from the pre-order sequence. After node D, we have node A, and then again we will go and check it into the post-order sequence where it appears. It appears before G, it means it is below node G. It appears before F also, and it also appears before D, node D, it means it is the part of node D. It has to be placed below node D. So we will draw it. D, and below that we have to place node A. But where to place it, whether to the left or to the right? We have to place it to the left because both the childs are absent. After placing node A in this tree, we'll again go and take the next element from the pre-order sequence. After node A, we have node B. Then we'll go again to check into the post-order sequence where node B appears in this traversal sequence. It appears before node G, it appears before node F, it means it is below node F. Then it also appears before node D, it means it is the part of node D. But we know that the left part of node D is already occupied. It must be placed, now the coming element node B must be placed to the right side of node D. So we'll draw it in the diagram. G, F, D, A, and node B to the right of node D. Why we place node B here? Because we know that the left part of node D is, we are having A here, it is already occupied. Whenever the left part is occupied, we have to place the coming element to the right side of node D. After placing node B here, again we will go to the pre-order sequence and pick the next element from the pre-order sequence, that is node E. We'll go back to check into the post-order sequence where node E appears. It appears immediately before node F. It means it is the part of node F. We'll check it into the diagram. The left part is already occupied. It means that we have to place node E to the right side of node F. We'll draw it here in the diagram. So the left part is occupied, so we'll put it into the right subtree of node F. the node E is placed to the right side of node F. Then after placing successfully placing node E into the diagram, we'll take the next element from preorder, that is our last element, that is node C. We'll check it into the postorder sequence where it appears. It immediately appears before node E. It means it is the part of node E. We'll check whether node E has left or right child. Both the childs are absent. It means that the node C must be placed to the left hand side of node E. So we'll draw it into the diagram. Here is node E, and to the left hand side of node E, we will place node C. So we have placed all the elements given in the problem in the binary tree. So it means that we reach to the final step of our designing of binary tree. So I can say that this is our final binary tree. Now to check whether this binary tree designed by you is correct or not, we'll again traverse this entire tree, this tree, in the pre-order fashion and then post-order fashion. And after traversing this tree in pre-order and post-order fashion, if you get the same this sequence, then we can say that our designed binary tree is correct, otherwise it is wrong. Thank you very much for watching the video.